Hi! In this short video, I will show you how easy it is to use the media browser to convert your files from one file format to another, such as WAV to MP3 or WMV to MP4, so that you can upload them to popular media playing devices such as iPhone, iPad, PSP, or upload to YouTube, burn to DVD, or email with and share with family and friends. So firstly, I'll begin by showing you how to convert an audio file into another file format. I'll start by finding my audio file within the media browser, and when I've selected my file, I can right click on the file to bring up the drop down menu. In the drop down menu, I simply select Convert To. When clicked, the Save Media To dialog box will appear. Here I can select a destination for my new converted file, and give it a new file name. In the Save As Type box, I can select a new file format. I can select either WAV, MP3, M4A, WMA, AUG, and FLAC. I would like to convert my WAV file to MP3, so I simply select MP3. When I've selected my file type, I can then choose my audio codec quality for my file. Here I'll select 128 kbps, which is CD quality, from the drop-down menu. I can also give my file tags, such as author, title, artist, genre, and add any comments that I would like. When I click Save, my file will be converted to MP3 and will be presented in the media browser. I can now use this file and upload it to my iPad, iPhone, PSP, the internet, burn to CD, and share with family and friends. So I'll now move on and show you how to convert a video file. Again, I'll find the video file that I'd like to convert and right-click on it and scroll over Convert. As you'll notice, this is different from the audio convert, as I'm presented with three different options. These are Convert To, Convert Audio Only To, and Convert Video Only To. Firstly, I'll begin with Convert To. Like with the audio convert, you can change your file format to a new file type. However, I would like to draw your attention first to the frame size. Ideally, you will firstly select the frame size, as this will detect where the borders and frame dimension will be set for your converted file. For example, if I'd like to convert my WMV to MP4 so that it will play on YouTube, I can click on the frame size and select YouTube Low Res. You'll notice that this and some of the other frame sizes are in bold. These selections shown in bold require specific encoding parameters and templates that are known to work. Once I've chosen my frame size, I can select a destination for my file and give it a file name. As I've selected YouTube Low Res in the frame size, the Save As type, the audio and video codecs, and the frames per second will be preset, as these parameters are known to work. Again, I can add tags such as author, title, artist, genre, and add any comments. When happy, click Save, and my file will be converted and presented in the media browser. I can now right-click on this file and directly upload it to YouTube. So now I'll go back and select another video to convert, right-click on it, and select Convert To. I'll go to the frame size and will select a frame size that is not in bold. You'll notice that all the drop-down menus are live, allowing me to choose different file formats, audio and video codecs, and frames per second. Again, I can select a destination and give my file a name. In the Save As Type box, I can choose a file format such as AVI, MP4, and WMV. Just a word of note, AVI files are uncompressed and can produce a very large file. Here I'll select MP4. In the Audio Codec drop-down box, I can choose the quality of the audio. Here I'll select 128 kbps, which is CD quality. In the Video Codec drop-down box, I have a choice between either converting to MPEG-4 or H.264. These are both MP4s, but H.264 will produce a higher quality file, but will take longer to encode. In the drop-down box, you can choose different levels of quality, level 1 being the lowest and level 5 the highest. Here I'll select MPEG level 5. In the frames per second drop-down box, you can choose the frame rate of the file. Again, the higher the frame rate, the better the quality, but the file will take longer to convert and be larger in size. Click Save and your file will be converted. The converting window will appear and present the details and progress. You are also able to convert multiple files at the same time. You are also able to pause and cancel the convert at any time. A really nice feature we've added is if you have a video with audio, you're able to convert either the audio only or video only. For example, if I have a video with a song I really like, I can right click on it and select Convert Audio Only To. I'll now be taken to the Save Media To dialog box, where I can convert the audio to a file type like MP3, thus separating it from the video. You'll notice the video codec frames per second and frame size have been disabled. This converting works the same as audio converting, as mentioned previously in the video. This works the same for video. I can right click on the file and select Convert Video Only To, and the Save Media To dialog box will again appear. I can select a new file format. You'll notice the audio codec drop-down menu is disabled. Once I'm happy, I can click Save and the video will be presented without the audio.